Look.
You best take that back.
You defiled sacred ground. The gods will never forgive you for this.
Ye ain't welcome here, witch.
Greetings, impressive tavern.
Tavern? This ain't no tavern. 'Tis the House of Warriors.
So what do folk do in the House of Warriors? Fight?
At times, one'll take the other and give him a good slapping, aye? But mostly, folk come here to drink, eat, warm their bones by the fire, chatter a bit. Maybe listen to a skald bay to the moon.
About what folk do at a tavern.
Ah, ye continentals don't understand a thing. You need some of our mead. Brewed wisdom it is.
What are you peddling? Let me have a look. Yearning to play a few rounds of Gwent.
Thank you.
You're a you, dimwit. Drop one more and I'll keelhaul you.
Got a minute?
Preparing my boat, can't you see? Nilfgaardian dogs were the hunters, some.
Got bigger game in mind. Morkvarg.
Ah, so them's your apples. All right, ask away. In praise of Freyr.
You were there when Morkvarg raided the garden. Heard you alone survived.
True. I managed to flee. Great Mother was looking out for me that day.
Mm-hmm. Bet she didn't give a lick about the priestesses.
Apparently. Morkvarg had them bound, then slit their throats like horses for the sacrifice. And he laughed. Understand? He laughed. But Archpriestess Ulver cursed him with her dying breath. You are beastly now, remain so forevermore. Ah, saintly woman.
What happened to Morkvarg?
Hard to believe, but fur rose through his skin, and his mug stretched forth into a muzzle like a dog's or a wolf's. He howled, long and grieving, then lunged at his men. They tried to run, but he was fast as lightning. As he killed them, clamped his jaws round their throats, they turned to ash, just like that. Ash that seeped from twixt his fangs.
Not good. Curse must be complex, multi-leveled.
Such is the Great Mother's power.
Didn't help the priestesses. Why not?
How could I? Alone against a dozen raiders that... Why are you staring?
Just wondering. You people, obsessed with honor, courage, and so on. But you just cut and run? Strange.
I ain't proud of it. Since that day, I've been seeking a worthy death at sea. Seems the goddess, she's not seen fit to summon me. Yet.
Thanks for your help.
Goddess, guide your sword.
Your axe never cleared.
Wonder if he's as strong as he looks.
A word?
I serve the goddess and her flock. What can I help you with?
You, Svana, you're about the hero's pursuits. Can outsiders sign up, or is this a closed event?
Freya sees no insiders, no outsiders. Any man can pay her tribute by risking his life in the pursuits. Our races differ from those on the continent. We are beholden to one rule alone. First across the line wins. Sometimes he's the swiftest, other times it is the one who knocks his opponents off their mounts.
Explains the name. There an entry fee?
Courage. If you do not lack it, hang a horseshoe.
Winner get a reward of any kind?
He covers himself in glory. Basks in proof of his valor.
Mm-hmm. Was hoping for something a little more tangible.
To us, such things matter least. But yes, the winner receives something to remind him of his feat. At times it is a sword, at others a helmet or a shield.
How about that? See, you can be practical if you want to. Don't lack courage. Time, though, that's another matter. Still might come back. Take care.
Your very names be cursed.
monster tracks. Running, chasing something. Fell through the crevice years ago.
Greetings. Praise Freya.
Liar.
What? I swear it on the great mother's tits.
Cut the act. Don't buy your piety one bit. You were one of Morkvarg's men.
Well, well. Sharp you are. Didn't see one thing, though. Lads here around me, they're mine. Armed to the teeth to the man. Let me introduce yous.
Can't wait.
You're daft. You're alone. What's your plan, eh?
Let me show you.
Still?